This guide will walk you through the settings that you need to turn off in macOS Monterey before you start the display calibration process. Let's find out together. This is ArtIsRight. Before we start, subscribe if you're new and hit on the bell icon so you'll be notified every time I upload cool new videos like this. If you have purchased a new Mac or upgraded operating system to macOS Monterey version 12 and above, the graphical user interface for the system preferences have changed, so I'm going to show you the settings that you need to turn off before you start a display calibration process, guaranteeing that you're going to get a successful calibration. Let's start out at the system preferences. If you have used the previous OS before, some of these settings are going to change in location. The names are going to remain the same, but I do have the previous guide that you can check out. Certain settings are going to be machine specific. So for instance, True Tone are going to be on the newer machines that has the camera and display built in. For instance, if you have a Mac Mini, you may not see the True Tone function, but we're going to talk about that when we get to it. Starting at the very top, I'm going to focus on desktop and screensaver because by default, macOS has screensaver set to turn on at around 20 minutes. I'm just going to go in and uncheck this, guaranteeing that the screensaver doesn't come on in the middle of the calibration and force me to start over again. You can certainly come back in and change all these settings back once you are done with the calibration process. The next thing I'm going to do is go into battery and make a few tweaks to the battery and the power adapter setting. If you don't have a laptop machine, you will not see the battery setting. You will only see the power adapter setting, so things are going to look slightly different. Turn display off is usually set to very low. Normally, when I'm calibrating display, I will pull this up to around like 1 hour or so. And this is so in the event that I lose power to my laptop, the display doesn't turn off or, you know, shut off in the middle of a calibration or anything like that. This way, you get a much smoother process. Your Mac may use more energy. It's warning you, I'm gonna say okay. I'm also going to uncheck slightly dim display while on battery power, because if you're calibrating, you lose power, you don't want the display to dim. And if you're just working, you're on battery power, you still don't want your display to dim. You want it to be at the correct brightness. I'll leave everything else a default and now click on power adapter and I'll do the same thing. Bring the display off time to 1 hour. I normally check this as well, prevent my Mac from sleeping when the display is off. This option is totally up to you, but the 1 hour thing is definitely going to help. Go back to the main screen and on the display, system preferences. So there's a few options that we can check. I would definitely recommend unchecking auto adjust brightness, especially redoing a calibration on your Mac display, because you don't want that to keep changing as your environmental change. Same thing with True Tone, because True Tone does not only affect internal display or the one built into your device, it will also affect external display link up to the system. If you're in a fairly consistent lighting environment, it's not a big deal. However, if you're in a room with natural light and it's constantly changing, you will see your display changing in color, and it will also affect external displays and internal one, causing the calibration to fail. So definitely disable True Tone before you go in and run the calibration. Now, with these new Apple Liquid Retina XDR displays, there are a few things. There are mini LED and there are reference mode that you can choose in the system. So you may say that for normal usage, you can't enable True Tone. If you prefer that, you can do it. However, when I'm just really browsing the web, I prefer to be an Apple Display XDR just so that if I'm watching an HDR content, my screen can ramp up to as high as 1600 nits and I don't have to worry about that. And I can change the brightness dynamically for just casual computer use. When I'm ready to go into pro workflow, what I do is go in and choose my preset that limits the display to 80 nits brightness. Now, if you want to learn how to do that and understand a little bit more of this and go through the entire process, I'll leave a video link to it up here and also in the description below so you can check that out. Otherwise, for the most part, you're good, and now you're ready to start the calibration process using either the software calibration program, or if you have an external display link up to your system, you can certainly use the appropriate software to calibrate that display. If you have any questions or comments, please send below. Give this a like, subscribe, and hit the bell if you're new, and remember, in art we trust.